our entire faculty members. So let me now join you all parents to give a loud ovation to our teachers for the excellent and outstanding work they are doing. To our respected parents, let me also tell you that you have a great responsibility at home. Our children stay at home longer than what they stay in school. Our children see our parents, they see you all. How do we talk? How do we conduct ourselves? How much do we apply ourselves in reading? How do we create an atmosphere of intellectual growth at home? Students are watching that. And therefore, my dear parents, please remember, we may not be engineers, we may not be doctors, we may not be PhD holders, but yet, at home, you are all the gods, the devtas, and the lords for our children. So please remember that how we behave, how we talk, how we conduct ourselves, how do we demonstrate simple values of living. And when I say simple values, they are in three sentences. I will not lie, I will not cheat, and I will not steal. If these three qualities are ingrained in our child at home, let me assure you, every child of ours will be none other than the greatest leader like Mahatma Gandhi, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, you name them all, our students are those characters. So everything begins, the fountainhead, the diya starts at home. So please do not leave a stone unturned towards the application, the emancipation of very fine qualities of parenthood to be transmitted into our child. And let me tell you, our children will never forget what they observe at home. The child may be in second standard. I remember my son telling me, today he is 35 years old, he says, I still remember, I was in second standard. And that day, you scolded my mother, and my mother had tears in her eyes. I can never forget that day, Dada, he tells me that. And I feel sad today that I raised my voice on my wife and the child saw it, and today the child is telling me, never raise your voice against your wife, against your dear one. So children never forget. They love us, they love the parents, and they acquire that insinuation, the propensity to generate near similar qualities like the parents. And therefore, we all owe to our children. We expect from the school, from our faculty, those attributes that will make our leaders strong, our children worthy and capable of being designated as the finest. I was very happy to give away the prizes to some of the best students here. There were only few students, but I'm sure all the 300 students who did not come on the stage, everyone deserves a prize. Because in them, they have demonstrated great qualities of studentship. So what we read, what we see, what we live up, and what we demonstrate is the aspiration of everyone that comes by. Let me share a small story with you. I take you back to 328 BC. That was the time when Alexander the Great, the great kingdom, the ruler of Greece, started his campaign and kept on conquering Europe. He captured the Mediterranean, North Africa, came into the Persian Gulf, he captured Iran, Iraq, Afghanistan, and his army came on the border of India. And when Alexander the Great with his army was standing opposite the Indus River, in our Indian border was King Porus. School valagi kati kedir bodhaniyo. Porus was the king of the Indian army. And he had horses, he had elephants, he had everything. But the world's best king, the greatest general, was known as Alexander the Great. Ek saal tak yudh hota raha Indus River ke upar. 17 times Alexander the Great launched his foray across the Indus River. But every time the Indian army kept on defeating him and sent him back. One day, at 6 o'clock in the evening, when Alexander was fighting the Indian army, 4 arrows came and hit him. And Alexander fell down from his horse. Alexander's horse was a white horse. The name of that horse was Bafliaz. Bafliaz died in that battle in Kashmir. And even today, there is a village whose name is called Bafliaz. And there is a memorial where this white horse has been buried there. And when Alexander fell down with 4 arrows into his chest, the doctor came to him and he said, "Me Lord, General, let's go back now. You have only 2 days to live. We must go back to Greece because here in India, they will destroy the complete Greek army." Alexander said, "Nahi, nahi, hum wapas nahi jayenge. Give me a letter and I want to write a letter to my mother." And he writes, "Nan priti atai, meri pyari ma, मेरी माय डियर मम्मी एंड ही राइट ही सेज मम्मी आपने तो एक बच्चे को जन्म दिया था उसका आपने नाम रखा अलेक्जेंडर द होल वर्ल्ड ट्रेम्पल्स दे शिवर व्हेन दे हियर द नेम ऑफ अलेक्जेंडर बिकॉज आई एम द ग्रेटेस्ट किंग ऑफ द वर्ल्ड बट हियर अपोजिंग मी इज द इंडियन आर्मी एंड एवरी सोल्जर ऑफ द इंडियन आर्मी इज इक्वल टू वन अलेक्जेंडर The soldier of the Indian army, he says, comes down like a ton of bricks. And all my horses had to leave the battlefield. I have got 2 days to live, ma. Mujhe ashirwad do, ki main is yudh ke maidan mein kabhi bhi apna peeth piche na dikhaun, dushman ki taraf. Aur sahi salamat main wapas aaun. And he gets back on the horse and he starts fighting again. Next evening, he gets 2 more arrows. This time the arrow hits him on his neck and he falls down again. The doctor goes to him. He says, "Alexander, sirf 2 ghante bache hain aapke paas. Only 2 hours and you will die. Let's go back. Run away from here. Indian army will not let us fight the battle." Alexander says, "Sawal nahi uthta hai. I will not go back. But get me the last paper and pen that you have. I will write a letter to my mother." And this Alexander writes the last letter to his mother and he says, "Nanna Prithiyatai, only 2 hours are left for me. I have only one desire. And that desire is when I die on this battlefield and when I am carried back as a dead general, I am carried in the coffin with the Greek flag on my coffin. I want my hands to be kept outside. I want the entire Alexander's army to see my open hands and I want the world to see that Alexander the Great has taken nothing from the battlefield. He goes empty-handed. Look at the character qualities of this general. He says, I require no property, no money, no gift, no nothing. All that I want to say is that my commitment, my izzat, my duty and my country shall always remain supreme and I'm willing to die on this battlefield with empty hands." Look at the attributes. So these are the stories. These are the kind of philosophical ideas. These are the virtues of human living. These are truthfulness which we must keep sharing with our children. So that as our child rises, girl or boy, they become strong leaders. They stand on that pedestal of propriety, correctness, value system. And one day, they will also wear big medals like this, as the teacher was saying, Param Vishish Seva Medal, Ati Vishish Seva Medal, Sena Medal, all that is here. Because I learned from my parents. I come from a very humble background. Very humble background. But I saw my parents at home, standing upright, teaching me the values of life, telling me to do my duty and stand with my head on my shoulders always. Kabhi jhuk ke nahi chalna, kabhi jhoot nahi bolna, kabhi buzdil mat banna. I think these are the attributes which are so critical. And a school like this, one of the best schools of our country, teaches us great attributes of knowledge, great skills of education, gives us good qualities of human living. What more do we need? So we are lucky that our children are all studying in a premier institution like this. And in 9 years, just 9 years, if you have achieved this much, I can dare say that in the next 2-3 years, your school will be one of the finest schools of our country, India. There are a lot of complexities, there are a lot of modalities for running an institution of this type. One of them, which I pointed out to you, is the value system. The second very cardinal factor, which I think is very important, is digitalization. Technology has changed the way the world will move forward. I was very happy to go into your computers center in the school, and I was very, very thrilled to see that students sit on computers and they are all able to access and modernize themselves. Technology is the change, is the future. And I'm very happy to note that the faculty members themselves are very good in computers. They understand the dynamics. They are teaching the students of how to operate computers, how to surf the net, how to extract knowledge from them and apply it in our overall academic curriculum. So my best wishes to all of you for getting upgraded into the field of technology, using technology as a force multiplier, and allowing that freedom to maneuver, giving that opportunity to every student and faculty to become stronger in the field of technology. The third very critical factor, I think, is the application of sciences and languages. Please remember that whatever discipline we go, whether we are an architect, you join the armed forces, you become a doctor, you become an engineer, you become a pilot, you become a painter, you become anything. Mathematics, sciences are very important. Very important. So the parents must keep on evolving. Give that knowledge of scientific orientation to our children. And don't try and chase that 98.5%. Please remember, 98 bandra na valledu, 99 bandra tumba valledu, 96 bandra addi illa, 70 bandra sumaraiti. These are all words that we should never use. Because remember, in that weighing machine, that tarazu, 99 and 98 really mean very little. An all-round development of the personality, as your principal was speaking in the opening remarks here, is a great attribute. Where you have a good shade of knowledge and wisdom, you have high skills of leadership, you have a sound bearing of humanities and other subjects, take part in extracurricular activities, and above all, you develop those qualities which I will now say becomes the fundamental block of the school. Things like creativity, issues of inquisitiveness, dynamics of rapid reading, the ability to memorize fast, these are some of the variables of creating good children. And I'm so happy that the faculty is allowing, teaching the children to become inquisitive, to question, to become more creative, to be able to play with clay, do drawings and paintings, to be able to write stories, be able to convert that knowledge into application. These are all steps of creativity. How important it is to be able to allow the mind to independently think. It's not enough, as I said, to get 99.9. Forget 99.9. But if the child is creative, is inquisitive, is able to forecast and see beyond the hill, to be able to grapple with multiple points of contact. I remember, there are so many Sainik School students here today, I'm proud. As a young boy in 5th standard, 6th standard, the dynamics of what we were all learning was enormous, enormous. We could see not one hill, two hill, three hill, and we anticipated what is going to come beyond the third hill. It comes from deep reflection. It comes from an analytical mind. It comes from the ability, the propensity to understand what are the adversarial positions. It's like playing chess. I would like someday every student of the school starts playing chess, because chess is a game of 52 parameters. You're constantly thinking. It's like a surgical strike. Like a surgical strike. You don't know where to strike, but yet you know in mind you're going to hit there. Whether it's Balakot, whether it is Rajouri, Nowshera, Lamb Valley, that's where the ambush will be laid. And Pakistan will never come to know where our aircrafts went. They struck and they all came back safe from there. I think by now, Abhinandan, our pilot, would have already crossed the Wagah border and he's come back. And those of you who saw